arrive when someone throws this whole like green warrior or like like slab on like label on you. I actually don't even believe in that anymore in that sense. I do believe this philosophy needs to just genuinely translate and permeate through your entire life. And it goes into your lifestyle, the way you interact with people, all the way to the production that you do. So to me, this is the beauty of how my family, like even sustainability in that sense has a lot to do with well-being, you know, and personal well-being. I don't know about you guys, but I think it's not ingrained in culture, in my culture. Self-care is not something that like I was inherently cultivated in. I only probably got it in my 30s. But I think the only reason why I got it as well is because the strong women in my life. And the having the ability to be, like to have self-care actually helps me a lot in my sustainability journey.
So last year I went through very severe burnout due to a very difficult year. And at the end of it, you know, I knew that I just didn't want to go through this again. So it was really important for me to be able to really block out time on a weekly basis. You know, now my weekends, I really try to minimize the amount of work that I do on the weekends, but also on weekdays, every single day, you know, I have pockets of time where I just stop and I reflect and breathe. And one of my favorite analogies is my friend JL, who's from The Great Room. She said, you know, we are always juggling so many things in our lives, but you know, we're juggling rubber balls that will fall and that will bounce back, but we're also juggling the glass balls in our life that when it falls and hits the ground, it's going to break and it's irreversible. So what are the glass balls in your life and what are the rubber balls? And for me, glass ball was my health. And my mental health, my physical health. How about for the both of you, Inge?
A lot of people always think mind over matter will solve the problem. I'm actually a believer of matter over mind. If I'm feeling terrible, having a hot shower helps me. You know, something or wearing something nice or feeling good about myself or finding what that thing of bringing joy is. So for me, my number one thing is hugging a cat.
Wow.
So every time I feel like it's not going great, like I take a pause, hug a cat, take like 15 minutes with a cat, and then I feel a lot better to do what I need to do. But to me, it's just that muscle of being able to put yourself first for a second or two, and then being able to go out and give again. And that to me is a muscle that really took me a really long time to practice till even in my 30s. It's just not ingrained in mostly as I observe in our culture, right? But it sounds like you also have a lot of challenges. Like, so how do you deal with like what the steps that you take for your mental health or for you to feel better?
I'm a passionate person, so I just keep going in. Do even if like, you know, any hard things, like, you know, okay, I will win more than others, like, you know, just go for it, like, you know, that is my character. But like, you know, it's actually like, you know, my daughter give me a lot of like, you know, the careless. I mean, like, you know, she just give me the hug and like, you know, make me like, you know, to feel better.
Recharge.
Yeah, and also like, you know, my husband also like, you know, he's kind of my mentor as well. Last year was like, you know, the pandemic started, like, you know, I was shocked and also like, you know, the burnout because I was preparing all the like, you know, the project which I like, you know, the done 2019, and then like, you know, it's we just started the. But suddenly, like, you know, COVID start, and then I was like, I don't know what to do, and then where to go, and then all must change. And then I was like, wow, I must do it, something.
This is the part that I find challenging in the last few years, where how do I still sustain myself without, I mean, it was before the pandemic, we were slated to go on tour, and then overnight, we suddenly had to rejig our lives. Was to be able to work with brands or people that I feel congruent with myself. So sometimes saying no to opportunity, income, and I feel like that has definitely shortened a lot of opportunities for me as a person. But I'm also very grateful at the same time because in this time, like what I'm hearing from both of your stories as well is that when there comes great challenge, there's a great opportunity to challenge yourself at the same time and readjust.
I mean, I think the same thing. And, you know, one of my biggest takeaway is that we can't ignore ourselves as well. You know, we're constantly giving and giving and giving so much of ourselves to our business, to our families. And we really need to be self-compassionate and to really also just be kind to ourselves.
Well, thank you, ladies, for this afternoon.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's been such a pleasure.
Oh, really?
I really enjoyed this conversation.
And you need to cook for us sometime.
Okay.
I know. And give us strawberries and persimmons.